The Philippines slams Taiwan for conducting live-fire drills near Ligao Island. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department called the military exercises unlawful. It points out Ligao Island is an integral part of the Kalayaan Island group, over which the Philippines has sovereignty. It adds Taiwan's illegal activity raises tensions and complicates the situation in the South China Sea. Turkey has dropped its objections to Finland and Sweden joining NATO. Finland's president said Turkey, Finland, and Sweden signed a joint memorandum that underscored their commitment to extend full support against threats to each other's security. The Nordic nations applied for NATO membership in May, but Turkey objected, accusing the two countries of harboring terrorists. This comes ahead of what is shaping up to be a critical NATO summit in Madrid. Their allied leaders will decide whether to invite Finland and NATO to join the alliance. Ukraine's President Volodymyr Zelensky urges the United Nations to visit the site of a deadly missile strike on a shopping mall in the city of Kremenchuk. Speaking at the emergency session of the UN Security Council, Zelensky says the UN can send a representative to independently confirm that Russia was indeed responsible for the attack on the building, which left 18 dead and 36 others missing. Moscow, however, is claiming it hit a nearby weapons depot, but the explosion sparked the blaze at the shopping center, which it insists was not operational at that time. G7 leaders urge countries and companies with large food stockpiles to help ease the hunger crisis sparked by Russia's war in Ukraine. They're also pledging an additional $4.5 billion to combat global food insecurity, bringing the total sum committed this year to more than $14 billion. The war in Ukraine, a country known as Europe's breadbasket, has pushed up food prices and led to shortages. This as Russia's blockade of Black Sea ports prevents millions of tons of grain from being shipped out. The crisis has sparked fears of famine in countries highly reliant on Ukrainian exports. Russia denies being responsible for the food crisis, blaming delivery disruptions on Western sanctions instead. Turkey has dropped its objections to Finland and Sweden joining NATO. Finland's president said Turkey, Finland, and Sweden signed a joint memorandum that underscored their commitment to extend full support against threats to each other's security. The Nordic nations applied for NATO membership in May, but Turkey objected, accusing the two countries of harboring terrorists. This comes ahead of what is shaping up to be a critical NATO summit in Madrid. Their allied leaders will decide whether to invite Finland and NATO to join the alliance. In other news, former U.S. President Donald Trump grabbed the steering wheel of his limousine in a bid to join the crowd marching on the U.S. Capitol last year. This was revealed to the House committee investigating the violence by Cassidy Hutchinson, an assistant to Trump's chief of staff, Mark Meadows. But Hutchinson said Trump demanded to march with a crowd. Hutchinson was a central figure in the administration and was able to offer the committee its first blow-by-blow account of activity inside the White House. She testified that Trump and some of his top lieutenants were aware of the possibility of violence, contradicting claims the assault was spontaneous and had nothing to do with the administration.
I was in the vicinity of a conversation where I overheard the president say something to the effect of, you know, I don't effing care that they have weapons. They're not here to hurt me. Take the effing mags away. Let my people in. They can march to the Capitol from here. Let the people in. Take the mags away.
As an American, I was disgusted. It was unpatriotic. It was un-American. We were watching the Capitol building get defaced over a lie.
On his social media network, Trump dismissed Hutchinson's claims as a fake story and called the House hearing a kangaroo court. The congressional panel has now held six public hearings to outline its initial finding. Trump led a criminal conspiracy to overturn his defeat to Joe Biden that led to the violence.